Hello everyone. Sir, Manimaran sir.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Sorry for the disturbance here. Okay, now we will move to today's workshop session. Today topic is antenna design and analysis with MATLAB and design analysis and visualize antenna elements and antenna arrays, especially for 5G antennas. And third one, design and analysis using antenna designer app using MATLAB. By using interactive app, we can able to design 5G antenna array. Antenna array or antenna element. Okay. Today the content, workshop content is discussed. Now, what are the key elements of antenna for 5G, especially for 5G networks? This is the features of 5G networks. These are all the three major issue, major users who can be fully supported to 5G networks. Here the diagram shows features of 5G networks. The 5G accelerating growthing is driving the need for all bands to implement 5G. What is the all band 5G? 5G means the all band to 5G transition requires antenna systems to support all type of bands, not only with 3G, not only with 5G, also it may be support to 3G, 4G and 5G. This is our aim and objective of 5G network antenna design. This so that it is called as all band to 5G transition support. Okay. In this manner, we are going to design 5G's multi-band and ultra-wide bandwidth capabilities are combined with. The important thing is massive MIMO to enable 5G networks to support 8 key features based on this band characteristics. Here, there is all 8 key features are there: energy efficiency, area traffic capacity, peak data rate, user experience data rate, spectrum efficiency and mobility and latency. Finally, the connection density. These are all the important 8 characteristics we are going to concentrate on when we are going to design a 5G antenna, so that we can use. Here there are what are the three main characteristic means. Here EMBB is nothing but enhanced mobile broadband. How does 5G deliver enhanced mobile broadband network? Based on that antenna only we are going to deliver enhanced mobile broadband. Here this is called EMBB stands for enhanced mobile broadband. Then next one, URLLC is stand for ultra reliable low latency communication. Here then what is the MMTC? Here massive machine type communication. These are all the three main characteristic, three main major cases we can fully support that when we are going to design the 5G networks. Okay. Here what is EMBB? Here this is the initial phase of 5G. It's a non-standalone deployment, mainly focused on EMBB, which provides greater data bandwidth, complemented by there's a moderated latency improvement such as 5G NR and 4G LTE network. Also, this EMBB system includes to develop today's mobile broadband use cases such as emerging AR, VR media and applications. Here, nowadays we are designing augmented and virtual reality based antenna system also they are trying. Here in this type of EMBB supports emerging AR, VR media and application, and also ultra HD or 360-degree streaming video and many more. Here MMTC is nothing but it has been already developed as fast of 3GPP release, especially for low power wide area technologies. That is also called as LPWA technologies. This technology, which includes NB IoT, these are expected to meet most 5G MMTC requirements, while other that require more bandwidth with ultra reliable load latency. Ultra reliable load latency means here URLLC will require the 5G core deployment for full end-to-end latency reduction. This is, in this point of view, we are considering while designing the antenna elements for 5G networks. Here, how does 5G deliver enhanced mobile broadband data? Here, this is the first we start with EMBB, that is enhanced mobile broadband. How our designed 5G antenna deliver the enhanced mobile broadband? Is a we are going to discuss about what technology we are going to use. One of the significant ways 5G will deploy across large areas is through fixed wireless access, that is called FWA, fixed wireless access, then which will leverage 5G technologies like beamforming and higher spectrum bands to deliver wireless broadband to previously unreached coverage areas. These are all the first thing we are going to deploy fixed wireless access technology. Then next one, we already discussed with all band to 5G transition requires antenna system to support all bands. It supports not only with the legacy bands, also support with them some special type of bands for 5G. Here, considering 5G network characteristic, antennas must be also flexible to adapt the diverse application scenarios. How we can achieve peak data rate and pursuit data rate? To achieve peak data rate and pursuit data rate while meeting area traffic capacity and mobility requirement, where antenna must support. Then all band configuration. One antenna must support C band and millimeter wave spectrum resources while enabling all sub 3 GHz band to support 5G NR features. Here is a precise beam coverage is essential. Here our beam shapes must be meet the requirement of application scenarios in the way of beam energy concentrated in the desired areas. The important techniques, massive MIMO with beamforming techniques is adopted to get the enhanced mobile broadband. Next title is all band to 5G transition requires antenna system to support all bands. Here the spectral we are going to discuss about spectral efficiency and power efficiency. What is the essential use for this type of antenna will support? First is we'll start with MU beamforming. MU beamforming is nothing but multi-user beamforming technique. By using this technique, we can allowing multiple user beams to share time and frequency domain resources to thereby maximize our 5G spectral efficiency. This can be achieved by implementing accurate null steering control on antennas to suppress the interference caused by the resource sharing. Then another important characteristic is power efficiency and connection density. These are all the three important parameters we are going to concentrate on whenever we are designing 5G antenna. Here power efficiency and connection density require for antenna. The first you concentrate on radiation concentration. Antennas must support precise antenna pattern control in accordance with coverage scenario to maximally concentrate irradiated energy on desired areas. Then low loss. Then antenna components are desired. The way to be included loss can be minimized so that same radiation power can ensure coverage with greater depth and with otherwise we have loss. If you go for high loss means this radiation power can be lesser depth and lesser width. So we concentrate on these three important characteristics, that is spectral efficiency, power efficiency and also connection density. Next one, the all band beamforming is a fundamental characteristic of 5G antennas. The figure shows the principle of beamforming technology. Why are using beamforming technology means to deliver higher speeds, massive connections, ultra low latency and premium user experience. 5G networks cannot use fixed broadcast beams of 3G and 4G networks. Here our all band to 5G transition, the antenna must support beamforming, then only it broadcasts beams on all type of bands. These are desired suppression and desired coverage areas. This is the general principle technology of the beamforming. Here the figure shows the 5G broadcast beams are group of a narrow beams of appropriate width and varied directivity shown in the figure. These narrow beams sweep across the target areas without leaving coverage holes in the target areas while having the minimal overlap coverage as well as the maximum RSRP and SINR. Here RSRP is nothing but reference signal received power. Here RSRP is stand for reference signal received power. Then SINR all are very aware about that. The word signal to interference and noise ratio. To create 5G broadcast beam with these characteristic 5G antennas must be supported with this beamforming technology. Then why high precision beamforming is mandatory for 5G antennas? These are all the this figure shows the multi-user beamforming accurate coverage. By using high precision beamforming, we can achieve the 5G requirements. Here, the accurate coverage of both 5G broadcast and traffic beams depend on beamforming. Here, our beam 1 and beam 2, these are transmitting one and receiving one. Here, your U is nothing but is your user equipment. Here, 5G traffic beams are more advanced than those for 4G, and multiple user beamforming has become a standard function. This function requires not only accurate pointing towards multiple user equipment to ensure maximal gains, but also accurate null steering to universal equipments. Only this way we can achieve maximum coverage, minimum interference, and optimal signal to interference and noise ratio. This is shown in the graph, the figure. To ensure higher RSRP and SINR, the 5G broadcast beams use beamforming to form a group of narrow beams of accurate widths and directivity. Therefore, the high precision beamforming is mandatory features of antennas to ensure consistent beam amplitude and phases between antenna arrays. Here, this is the coordinated design also the fundamental attribute of 5G antennas. The previous one, the 4G antenna design, this involves component level simulation and test the aim to maximize capacity and coverage performance through antenna pattern optimization. Whereas our 5G coordination, it is a radio access network. There is a RAN, nothing but remote radio access network. Antenna coordination will reach unprecedented levels depending on applicable object. It is characteristic as component level, product level, and features level. Component level includes array amplitude, phase consistency, and power capacity, thermal design, system isolation. Here, product level mainly focus on the integration between active and passive antennas to improve 5G network deployment. Whereas this component level coordination focus on the design and optimization also possible. Design and optimization of antenna elements, arrays, and feeding networks to meet 5G network configuration and performance requirements. Then this is the third one is the feature level. The feature level coordination matches 5G network planning and also in the application with better implementation of high precision beamforming. This is LTE, there is a long time evaluation, new radio sharing, and other features. These are the coordinated design is a fundamental attribute of 5G antennas. So we have to concentrate on this coordinated design in three levels. That is, the first one is the component level, second one is the product level. The feature level we are going to concentrate whenever we are designing the attribute of 5G antennas. The next one, the feature level collaboration facilities implementation of 5G. Here the figure shows the end-to-end calibration on a wireless network equipment. This figure shows the antenna element splitter, combiner, and IO port, RF connector, and transmission calibration. And this brown line indicates transmission calibration, and this one indicates receiver calibration. This figure illustrates how end-to-end calibration enables high precision beamforming by accurately tuning phases for network lines. In 4G, applications are MIMO prioritized and beamforming is optional. Where when you go for 5G, in 5G, beamforming is a basic capability for all bands, making all band calibration a fundamental requirement. If I go for radio links, phase difference occurs as a baseband configured weight assignment travels. It's a RRU. RRU is nothing but radio remote radio unit. jumpers and other devices before it reaches the antenna, and as a result of cumulative tolerance of components and assembly. Here, high precision beamforming is utilized, and also it requires phase difference to be eliminated or measured, for which phase calibration for both RRU antenna links and inside antenna must be used. Then only this is the feature level collaboration facilities implementation of 5G. Which is, that is the next one. What is the challenges when you are designing massing MIMO arrays for 5G? If you go for 5G technology, 5G network, we are going to design massive MIMO arrays for 5G network. Here, what are the challenges we are discussing? As 5G standards continue to evolve, the goals for higher data rates, lower latency network access, and more energy efficient implementations are clear. Here, higher data rates drive the need for greater bandwidth systems. The available bandwidth in the spectrum up to 6 GHz is not sufficient to satisfy these requirements, so that we are moving above 6 GHz. This has moved the target operating frequency bands up to into the millimeter range for the next generation of wireless communication system. To achieve the most control of flexibility with the beamforming in an active array design, here we are concentrating on massive MIMO array design. This is achieved by using MATLAB interactive array analyzer, sensor array analyzer app. By using this app, you can design the massive MIMO arrays. To achieve the most control and flexibility with beamforming in an active array design, it is desirable to have independent weighting control over each antenna array element. Here it has to be independent weight control over each antenna array element. This requires dedicated module, that is a transmit-receive module to each element. For array sizes that are typically a massive MIMO communication system, this type of architecture is difficult to build due to its cost, space, and power. These are the challenges. We are based on this challenges, we are concentrating this characteristic. We are design massive MIMO arrays with optimized design. Here, antenna toolbox, having antenna toolbox along with phased array system toolbox, you can optimize the antenna array also by using this antenna array optimizer app. Here, next, what is the basic concept of hybrid beamforming architecture? This hybrid beamform architecture is a technique you can use to partition beamforming between the digital and RF domain. First, it is start with the digital and RF domain. The system engineers can implement hybrid beamforming to balance flexibility and cost trade-offs while still fielding systems that meets the required performance parameters. Next, the hybrid beamforming designs are developed by combining multiple arrays elements into subarray models. These are the important process in hybrid beamforming design, by combining multiple array elements into subarray models. Here already we dedicate the transmit and receive model to a subarray in the array. Therefore, fewer transmit receive models are required in the system. Here utilization of TR module is reduced by using hybrid beamforming design. The number of elements and the positioning with each subarray can be selected to ensure system level performance is met across a range of steering angles. Steering also we have to concentrate for in hybrid beamforming technique. Here, how you designing the array? How you can design the array? What is the step following we are discuss? There are many factors to consider when designing an array. Typical array designs include parameters such as array geometry, element spacing, lattice structure, and element tapering. These are all the parameters we have to concentrate on whenever we are designing antenna arrays, especially for 5G network array antennas. Then, in addition, the effects of mutual coupling are also important to characterize before the final decision is implemented. Once an initial configuration of the array design is complete, architectural partitioning can be iteratively evaluated. This is the important point. How it is evaluated iteratively means by using our MATLAB interactive app against the overall system performance goals. With millimeter wave systems, the area of the array is reduced in proportion to the wavelength size. As an example, an antenna array designed to design at millimeter wave frequencies can be up to 100 times smaller than array designed to operate at microwave frequency. This is one of the best example for antenna array designed at millimeter wave frequency. We can use up to 100 times smaller than the array designed to operate at the microwave frequency. By building an array with large number of antenna elements, we can achieve a high beamforming gain. We can achieve high beamforming gain means by building an array with large number of antenna elements. We are going to utilize large number of antenna elements so that we are using massive MIMO communication system. We are going to use to design of these 5G antenna arrays. Here, the highly directive beams helps to offset the increased path so that we are getting higher frequency of operation as beams are steered to a specific direction. First, this is specific direction. Here, this is the app model of sensor array analyzer app. By using this app, this is coming under phase array system toolbox along with antenna toolbox. Here, designing the array using sensor array app. Using this app, we can easily visualize the resulting geometry and 2D and 3D directivity, and also the grating globe diagram also we can be able to see. Here array settings, in this array settings, array type, we have to specify the array type. It may be uniform rectangular or uniform circular. So what type of array we are going to use, you are depending upon your requirement, we have to specify the parameters. This is the element type, and we have to give the diameter, spacing, signal frequencies and lattice, array format, so that so many things are there. If we here in terms of hertz to gigahertz range, you can be able to design here. There is some options are available here. Also one more settings is array settings. Also we can one more settings are there, visualization settings. In these settings we can able to view 2D, single D and 2D, 3D array directivity in this interactive app. Also based on this your specifications, it shows the array characteristic in here. What is your array directivity and what is your array steer angles also your see. You can edit all the design parameters that define an array directly on the left hand side of the app in the array settings. The figure, this one. Then to a pattern, you can design a uniformly spaced planar array. This is a important one. You can design a uniformly spaced planar array. Then when the process of designing array is completed, we can generate MATLAB code from this app and either use directly in your model or as a starting point for further customization. It may be acted as automation process. If you convert into MATLAB code directly, you can you can change for automatic, for number of iteration you can change, you can use. How you can get the app through MATLAB? In my MATLAB command window, you have to type this command, sensor array analyzer. To start the array design process, the sensor array analyzer app, which available in first array system toolbox, can be launched from the MATLAB prompt in this manner. Next, then for example, we are designing in practice session. Anyone of you having MATLAB software in your laptop, means we can try with this app. In break time, anyone of you can share your screen. We can analyze by using the sensor analyzer app how we can get the 3D directivity pattern and see what is your lobe diagram. You can see. Anybody interested means can unmute your mic, can tell. Participant, please cooperate with me. Nobody using MATLAB now? Dear participants, my voice is audible? Yep. Okay, man. Thank you. Anybody having MATLAB software in your laptop? In meantime, you can share your screen. by using this interactive sensor analyzer app. Just you type in my type at command prompt, this command sensor analyzer, this application window will come. Based on that, you can create this 64 cross 64 uniform rectangular array. Array was designed with this sensor listener app. Also, you can get the log diagram. If you select here the 3D array directivity, 2D array directivity pattern, here also you can see the log diagram like this. Now Navi. Okay, with half wavelength spacing between the element, there are no grating lobes. These are grating lobe diagram in UV space at our 64 gigahertz with no steering. These are all shows the green line shows GL, that is a grating lobe free area, and in the another color shows the GL area. This is a free area. The green shows the free area. The center is a main lobe is situated between this center point of this lobe. This is our achievement of designing of a uniform rectangular array. It is important to understand the impacts here because it may be necessary to increase the spacing between the elements to mitigate the effects of mutual coupling. The figure shows the beam pattern and grating lobe diagram for 66 gigahertz 64 cross 64 element design. Then the large number of elements provides high level of directivity. Already we discussed about with the beamforming technology, or we have to get the achievable requirements. The large number of elements provides a high level of directivity. The design has tapered applied to the rows and columns of the array to reduce side lobe levels. The design tapering applied to the rows and columns of the array to reduce the side lobe levels. The larger antenna gains achieved with narrow beams must be balanced with the fact that MIMO systems are based on scattering environment that also depend on broader beam patterns to maximize channel capacity. This trade-off can also can be assessed during the interactive design process. Now we are go for previous one is the antenna array design option. This is with one example. Now we are going to design antenna and analysis using this graphical user interface. It's a introduction to this agenda. Introduction to antenna designer tool, getting started with the antenna toolbox. Then for that we are going to select one simple helix antenna and design and analysis using app. That is using app means your GUI. Then another one by using this command line interface, the helix antenna modeling using command line interface. In command line, MATLAB command prompt itself, we can do with this antenna modeling. Here one example for rectangular array modeling and analysis. Another one is planar inverted F antenna, that is FIFO antenna port analysis. Then finally we are visualization analysis of an antenna. This is the first one, dipole current and the Yagi-Uda antenna for far field and dipole for near field visualization we are going to discuss. Then let's start with what is your antenna toolbox having this antenna designer tool. The antenna design and analysis tool is a powerful user interface for designing, analyzing and visualizing the antennas quickly. What is the use of this tool? This tool enables you to design and analyze the antennas. First you start with design standalone antennas and build arrays of antennas using either predefined elements with parameterized geometry or arbitrary planar elements. How to compute the port properties such as impedance, surface properties, current and charge distributions, and the field properties such as near field and far field pattern. By using this antenna designer tool, you can compute. You can also visualize the antenna geometry analysis in result in 2D and 3D views. Then next one provides radiation patterns for simulating beam forming and beam steering algorithms. Here this radiation patterns also provides for simulating beam forming and beam steering algorithms. Also it supports. you can generate Gerber files. These are Gerber files generally need to manufacturing in printer circuit boards antennas, PCB antennas. When you are designing PCB antennas, the Gerber file is need. For that, when you are designing through this antenna designer tool, we can generate Gerber file also. This is another advantage of this tool. Then getting started with the antenna toolbox. By using this antenna toolbox, using predefined or custom elements, you can design a rapid design and visualization of antennas. Here, design of arbitrary printer structures, that is a PCB, and Gerber file generation for antenna manufacturing. Design of linear, circular, rectangular, conformational, and custom antenna arrays we can design. Large array analysis is possible, port analysis is possible, and radiation field analysis and surface analysis is possible. Here, large array analysis using the infinite array or embedded element pattern approach. Here, then port analysis of impedance, return loss, and S parameters of antennas and antenna arrays. Then, radiation field analysis of the pattern, it is a E and H, VH pattern and beam width of antennas and antenna arrays and custom data. Surface analysis of antenna and antenna array, current, charge, and meshing using this antenna toolbox. First, you start with Helix antenna design and analysis using this antenna designer app. Okay, this example shows how to construct, visualize, and analyze antenna elements using the antenna designer app. To open the app in MATLAB command prompt, just you type antenna designer. Now, parallel you can do with this one. In MATLAB command window, just you type antenna designer. In the when you got the antenna designer app, in the one blank canvas will come. Here you have to type, you have to click new. Then in the antenna gallery under others, you select the Helix antenna. You may be select several antennas are in the options. Here you can set the design frequency. But start with 1.8 gigahertz. Based on your requirement, you can select the design frequency, you can select the type of antenna. Here, a simple example I am taking here, so that I choose a Helix antenna. The blank canvas is available now. Here, you click new. Here click new. In the antenna gallery under others, select a Helix antenna. Here this is the antenna gallery. There are the four parts are there. First one antenna gallery part, and second one is backing structure, and the third one is design frequency. Finally, if you are set the parameters, select your antenna, you can click accept. It will shows the simulated output. Here there is some antenna gallery options. I am choosing Helix. If your aperture, that is a waveguide or horn antenna, dipole family, loop family, and monopole family, and others, other type of antennas, and patch families, so patch antenna here, microstrip antenna, inverted F coplanar, inverted L coplanar, inset feed patch antenna, that is a circular patch antenna, spiral antenna, all type of antennas are available here. Within the click, you can able to design all things by using this antenna designer app. Here, for understanding purpose, I am choosing the simple Helix antenna. In Helix antenna, just you design, set the design frequency to 1.8 gigahertz. Here, I am choosing 1.8 gigahertz. Up to terahertz options are available here. So that we can design design frequency, operating frequency you can choose. Here you can select radiation or directional, warmly directional. Here polarization you can select, circular or linear polarization you have to apply in the antenna, and bandwidth also you can apply here. And this is our, the legend shows the metal and feed. Here you can also rotate the dipole helix antenna element at three different directions also possible. Okay, now next one, to analyze the helix antenna, click accept. For a design frequency is 1.8 gigahertz. What happened? We'll check. Click accept. Next one. After accepting, we have to change the antenna properties. Adding show plot. Here, this is the default one. Here, here you can change the value. For example, 0.0280. I am giving here. Zero point 0283 width is 0.0012. Based on your requirement, you can change the antenna properties. Spacing is 0.0350. Here ground plane radius is. Here also you can select your impedance or next click apply, finish updating. In antenna of the wait a minute. Here in antenna designer, in MATLAB command window, you just type the command, you will get this app. Yes, madam. First, we start with this case, command window is a case sensitive. You start with the antenna. You carefully you D capital. What version you are doing, madam? 13. Okay, your antenna designer is coming up. Just you check, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Then this is our antenna designer app. Based on that, you can get the dipole helix antenna element. Here, these are the parameters we are changing. How to plot the then I want to see the impedance. Just you click. Meantime, you just what are the here open the plot to plot the impedance and the S parameters. These are the steps for vector frequency analysis and scalar frequency analysis. Take some more time, wait for some time. It need to correct is up to 21 frequency point. It's calculating to 12th frequency point. Now you can click impedance, means you will get the impedance chart between your frequency versus impedance. Then if you want to S parameter, you will get the S parameter value and the current distribution and 3D pattern also you can get. The current distribution, calculate the surface current distribution at your plot frequency. Next one, we will get in the 3D pattern. This is our interactive 3D pattern of our design, dipole helix antenna design. Then how to find the azimuth pattern and elevation pattern. Here one more option is there to plot the impedance and S parameter. Here load helix session, here load helix session is there. In this session we are change the impedance of the antenna to your value. Is here also you can choose the impedance value. For example, I am choosing 72 ohms. I'm loading a frequency also you can give, and location phase, location feed location. Now the same thing on the tool strip here. Here in the frequency range also you can type under the frequency analysis tab, change the frequency range. Here this is a frequency range is 1.6 gigahertz to 1.9 gigahertz. For example, we are here we have changed the frequency range. For example, 1.7 gigahertz to 2.2 gigahertz. Here is a middle term, nothing but gigahertz. So there is a 1.8. Also, you can click the experimental plot. S11 value of the helix antenna will be shown. Also, here by using CSD or any other type of tools are only for particular application. Here we can able to convert into MATLAB code, so that we can automate your iteration process for there, for so that we the same design we can analyze, and also we can optimization option also there. Once you design the antenna array or antenna elements, you can optimize the design by using this MATLAB. I don't know about the CST and the Microwave Studio, there are giving optimization option or not. Here we are getting in interactive way without knowing any programming knowledge. Then next we are going to discuss with some MATLAB inbuilt functions. Here anybody can design any type of antenna here without knowing you must be knowing impedance, what is impedance, what is directivity, what is radiation pattern, nothing you can know. For example, here any type of antenna we can design. Also you can generate codes. Also you can view the pattern. Based on that instant patterns we can analyze. For example, the geometry pattern dipole helix, my radius is this one, my width is this one. Obviously directivity pattern is come. How it is made, radiation pattern, how we can analyze the side lobe distortions. So many things are there. So many things we can easily analyze by using this MATLAB. Yes, madam. Yes. Can convert. Okay. Next to plot current, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Next session, I'm going to do this one. Okay. Next, this is the same one, the plot current distribution and 3D azimuth and elevation pattern in the scalar frequency analysis section of the tool strip. Click current and 3D and AZ pan and EL pattern. Here you can get first for this tile operation, what are the analysis we are going to do, seen in same window. First one is your directivity, and second one is your S parameter value, impedance chart, and current distribution, 3D pattern, and azimuth and elevation pattern also there. In this, based on that you can do this one. Here madam is asking export to workspace. For example, if we export workspace, means the MATLAB command window. Here export to Vantana workspace with variable and dipole, helix, antenna, designer. Here this you can see the properties of this dipole, helix, antenna. Then also you can generate code. The script is generated by antenna designer. Then here our plot frequency is 1.8 gigahertz. Here itself you can change your plot frequency. Here itself you can change your frequency range. Here itself we can plot what type of plot you want. It may be impedance, or it may be S parameter, it may be 3D or 3D azimuth pattern. Here you can change and run. You can automate your process. You can repeatedly do with this antenna design. Not only with the particular type of antenna, here itself we can change the antenna range also there, antenna types. Okay, here this is the important application of this antenna designer app. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. Next one, this is a general snapshot of the step-by-step procedure. I already do this one. Next one, this is the plot characteristic. Previous one with scalar vector frequency analysis as an under impedance and S parameter, and then scalar frequency analysis, current 3D pattern, AIZ pattern, and AL pattern. Next one. The scalar frequency analysis, there are the steps. We are getting the all type of output windows in same window. Then this is the snapshot showing the export button arrow, and click export to expose to view the helix antenna variables in MATLAB command line. Then the export your antenna design to MATLAB script. Now we are going to design with command line interface, not with this app. In command line itself we can create the same thing. Here you type just hx equal to lx, what will happen you check in command line window. You just put this one. In this, if you type this command, you will get the helix antenna with the properties of this default one. Then you have to show the what type of antenna. Here we are getting this dipole helix antenna element. Here you have to give the radius. Now we are modifying the, in this command we will modify the properties of helix antenna. Previous one is default one. Here we are modifying the properties of radius, width, and number of turns here. Here it shows the antenna with this one. Based on that, you are follow this procedure, you can get the radiation pattern with single command. You will get the helix antenna pattern for where you are designing 1.8 gigahertz pattern will come. These are 3D pattern of your designed antenna. The output is directivity. Their frequency is 1.8 gigahertz. Your maximum value of dBA is 10.1 and minimum value is -13.1. And the elevation is -90° to 90°. Azimuth angle is -180° to +180°. Yes, done that. You can plot Canton azimuth. You can get this way. Previous one, one is without having this quotes. What is the command to get the pattern? That is, you have to type pattern and helix. What type of antenna? What is your frequency? 1.8 GHz. Here, by using this app, now easily we can type, easily we can analyze with this single window. Here we are by using this, how to find the directivity of this antenna. This it shows the directivity 10. You can see. Directivity at 1.8 GHz, it shows the directivity pattern. Then how to calculate the EH fields. This is a command to get the EH field. It shows the EH values. See, after hitting this command, you will get E field value and H field values. Here, this is the output it shows. And next one, how to find the polarization, different types of polarizations. This type of polarization, just you enter. Okay. In this manner, you can get the another one, the axial ratio of antenna. In app, it is not possible. It is not possible. Here the actual ratio of antenna, here you can see in MATLAB command window. These are actual ratio values 25.111006. And next, the calculate the beam width of an antenna. This is a command to get the beam width of a particular antenna. It shows the 57 and 60 117 value. These are output values also discussed in PPT session. How to calculate the impedance? When it calculates at the 501 frequency points, because I am using 1.7 GHz to 2.2 GHz, so that it takes some more time. So, next, also you can find the return loss of the antenna. Not only the helix antenna, you can choose any type of antenna, you can model any type of antenna, you can do analysis in this manner. You can find also return loss, you can see the scalar frequency analysis and vector frequency analysis. This is the command you use to get the return loss. You have, after reading this command, you will get the return loss. So how to calculate the impedance of the antenna? Use the impedance function. This is a function name, MATLAB function called impedance. They say use the impedance function to calculate and plot the input impedance of helix antenna, and input impedance is a ratio of voltage and current at the port. Then antenna impedance is calculated as the ratio of phasor voltage, which is 1 volt, then angle of 0 degree. As mentioned earlier, then and the phasor current of the port is displayed here. Next one, how to calculate the S parameter for each and every port. This is a calculate the reflection coefficient of an array. Next, use the S parameter function. This is a S parameter function to calculate the S11 of helix antenna. It is an antenna reflection coefficient also. You can find by using this R of power, this one antenna reflection coefficient S11 describes the relative fraction of the incident R of power and is where reflected back to this impedance mismatch also. You can find this is where R of antenna reflection coefficient. Next one, the how to calculate the VSWR value. By using the VSWR function, we can find VSWR value. You have to type this function name, that is a VSWR. You have to specify the type of antenna. Here in MATLAB function, if you go for MATLAB help, what is the keyword for such type of antenna? For example, helix antenna, you have to type HX. There is so many keywords are available for the different types of antennas. Here you have to give the specification 1.7 to 2.2 gigahertz. Also, you have to give the impedance also here, 72 ohms here your impedance. Here how to calculate the current and charge distribution of an antenna. Here to calculate the charge distribution of helix antenna, you have to use the charge function, that is a charge helix antenna. It's 2 gigahertz, and figure command used to get the plot the figure. And this is the current function to calculate the current distribution of the helix antenna. Next one, how to find the mesh of antenna. You have to mesh antenna. This is a command. You have to get the mesh function is used to create and shows the mesh structure of an designed antenna. In this process, the electromagnetic solver can process the geometry and material of the antenna. The shape of the basis or the discriminating element for subdividing the antenna surface is a triangle one. Next one, this array modeling analysis. Previous one, antenna modeling and analysis is there. Now we are going to discuss about array modeling and array analysis. How to create an antenna array using these antenna elements. For example, here one more app is available here. Now we are start with the MATLAB command window also there. Here MATLAB command window itself, we are model the array, any type of array. For example, I am choosing rectangular array. Just you. After finished one, then only it starts. Then this array modeling and analysis, the example, how to construct, visualize and analyze an antenna array from the antenna toolbox. Here by using this antenna toolbox, you can create antenna array using antenna elements. Create a default rectangular array using the rectangular array element in the array library. Here there are so many libraries are there, rectangular array library. And so uniform array library, so many array libraries are there. Here by default this array uses the dipole antenna as a element. Here after reading this command in command window, you will get this information about the array properties, what type of element is there, 1x1 dipole, and what is the size 2x2, what is your row spacing, what is your column spacing, what is the lattice structure, amplitude, taper and phase shift also there. Here itself we can change the phase shift, we can apply the phase shift. We have to visualize the layout of array. The layout function is used to plot the position of array elements in the XY plane. By default, the rectangular array is 4 element dipole array near 2x2 lattice array. This is our impedance for 72 ohms helix antenna design. Now you start with array modeling. So just you do with array modeling. That is shows the information about the rectangular array with properties, what is the element size and row spacing itself. Then how to visualize your antenna array, that is the layout function used to visualize your rectangular array. This is our array design layout. Then next step is visualize the geometry of array. So what is this function is used to show RA, that is a show function is used to view the structure of rectangular array. User, the function is used to view the rectangular array of dipole antennas. Similarly, you can plot the radiation. Plot the radiation function by using this pattern function to plot the radiation pattern of rectangular array. The radiation pattern is the spatial distribution of the power of an array. The pattern displays the directivity or gain, directivity or gain of the array. By default, the pattern function plots the directivity of the array. Here the pattern got. Next, how to plot the azimuth and elevation pattern array. Here your directivity and azimuth pattern directivity. The element, this is our azimuth pattern, and this is our element elevation pattern. Here this is a function to calculate directivity of an array. The same procedure for antenna element and antenna array. For here, this is a command, this is a function to calculate directivity of the antenna. This is a rectangular array antenna. This is a directivity is ability of array to radiate power in a particular direction. It can be defined as the ratio of maximum direction radiation intensity to the desired direction and average direction intensity and all the direction. Here by using the pattern, use pattern, you will get the directivity, right? -38.6765. You are getting the correct value. Then calculate EHF fields. EHF fields here you can hit the command, you will get the E and H value. E field value and H field value you will get. And H. Next one, you plot the polarization of different type of polarizations by using this command. Here we will get the output directivity. Frequency 70 megahertz maximum value. Here the description is available in this figure. Here madam asking how to get the code from my MATLAB figure, the output figure. Here we can get the figure output, we can generate code here. Okay, and this is you can get the code as a function. We'll create using this is auto generated by MATLAB at 15 December 20. There's a same time. Okay, here you will get the MATLAB code. Okay, clear, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Next one. Yes, ma'am. What, madam? I can't understand. Yes, ma'am. I will share the PPT, PPT in group, ma'am. Yesterday PPT also shared. This PPT also I will share. Based on that you can use. Based on that you can use. Thank you. Here then you can calculate the beamwidth of an array. This is a beamwidth array. You can find the beamwidth and angles also. You will get function to calculate the beamwidth of that array pattern. Then beamwidth angle is measured in plane containing the direction of main lobe array. Scan impedance of array. You can by using this impedance function to calculate the plot the input impedance of our rectangular array. Based on that, you will get. Frequency. In this manner, you can get the active impedance. Plot between this is a solid line shows the resistance, and this dashed line shows the reactance value. By using the MATLAB functions, you can analyze the arrays and model the arrays interactively. Also, by using this command S parameters command, you can calculate reflection coefficient and array. After hitting this command, you will get this information like this: how many number of ports, how many frequencies are available, how many frequency band and parameters, impedance, also you can get. Is here this output, this S parameter values.